Hello students, today we are going to discuss question answers of the poem Cherry Tree. Let's start with question number 1. Find proof from the poem for the following. The poet has mentioned different seasons. Now you have to tell the lines where the poet has used different seasons. Now see here, in this line, and suddenly that summer near the end of May. Here he has mentioned summer season. Then this one, split it apart and a monsoon blight. Here monsoon season is mentioned. Then next spring I watched 3 new shoots grow. Here the spring season is mentioned. So these are the 3 examples, or you can say proof for that particular question. Then the poet's minute observation of the steady growth of the cherry tree. Now from which line we come to know, or which lines we come to know that poet was very minutely observing the growth of cherry tree? Here you can say this one. See, and suddenly that summer near the end of May, I found a cherry tree that had come to stay. It was very small, 5 months old child. Very small, 5 months child. See how he is observing. Suddenly he realizes that the 5 month old small cherry tree has grown in his garden. Then here you can also say, see here. Next spring I watched 3 new shoots grow. Again here he realizes, or he sees that the new shoots have grown there. Understood? So from this you can say he was very minutely observing the cherry tree. One more example, you can also say after that, that when he returns back from Kashmir, then he saw the cherry tree, a berry was there on that. That line also you can mention if you want. Then the color imagery in the poem. Which colors are mentioned in the poem? See here, one thing. Pink, fragile, quick to fall. Pink color blossoms. Pink color flowers are mentioned. Then here you can say this one. It and I could scarcely believe it, a berry ripened and jeweled in the sun. Means it was so ripe that it was shining like a jewel, golden color or red color, like that he wants to tell us. So here you can say that color is mentioned. Then again, where you can see the colors mentioned in the poem. See green growing pen here, green color grass growing, or green color this one made a miracle from green growing pen. Here the cherry tree color, that green color cherry tree is growing, bearing all the you can say struggle against the goats, or you can say the human beings, means the grass cutter who had come and cut it down. So again it had grown. So the green color mentions the cherry tree. So here green you can say one color is mentioned. Then this jeweled in the sun, the color of the berry is mentioned here. Then pink and fragile, the flowers color, pink color flower. So here, then this one, see here, blue blind sky, blue color sky is also mentioned. So all these colors, see, dappled green, flitted through the dappled green. So here this one, dappled green cherry tree is mentioned here. Understood? So all these colors are used in the poem, mentioned in the poem. Then the struggle of the cherry tree for survival. How it was struggling to survive. Now see here, here they have mentioned that the goats ate the leaves, the grass cutter sky split it apart, and monsoon blight. So because of all this thing, it was completely destroyed. But again, next spring, he watched that three new shoots had grown. And the young tree upward thrust, means it was trying to move upwards, it was trying to grow upwards against all the, you can say, wild grass around it. So this is the example for that question. Now, true and false. And you have to give evidence from the poem to support your remark if your sentence is false. The cherry tree did not take long to grow. It is false. It took a long time to grow. First line is the evidence for that, that it took 8 years to grow. After that, birds and insects were benefited from the tree. Yes, it is true. Like you can say, bees were drinking nectar from the blossoms and the birds were flying around it. They had built their nest on it. And this, yeah, so the statement is true. The poet was exalted at the sight of the cherry tree. Yes, he was very happy. The statement is true. The poem has an underlying message about the importance of tree. Yes, it is telling us the importance of tree. The statement is true. The poet repents planting the cherry tree. False. He doesn't repent. On the other hand, he is very happy. The last lines here. Yes, I praise nights and stars and tree, that small cherry tree grown by me. Means he is very proud that he has grown the small sapling into a tree now. After that, discuss in groups reasons, consequences and effects. Now see, the life of the cherry tree was threatened. What was the reason for that? It was threatened by the, you can say, animals. Goat has eaten it up. Human beings, the grass cutter has come and split it apart. And you can say the weather, because of, you can say, monsoon, it had been completely destroyed and all. These were the reasons. Consequences, that it was completely destroyed, but still again it grew, overcoming all the adversities. And what was it, the effect? The effect was that, you can say, it had to overcome all the adversities and still grow. And because of that, what happened? And finally, after, you can say, 7 years, it had grown into a 6 feet tall tree. The cherry blossomed. Yes, the cherry blossomed here. What are the reasons here? It is given in the, in this stanza, that after the poet returned from Kashmir, he saw the cherry tree had grown 6 feet high and it was bearing now a berry also, which was very ripe and jewel. It had blossoms here which were very pink, fragile and quick to fall, because they were so delicate that with the slightest breeze, or you can say with the slight breath also, it could fall down. After that, a small thought put in action led to a great achievement. Pick out lines from the beginning and end of the poem and explain their significance. Now, a small thought put in action and led to great achievement. We have to give examples of the line. So here, the first one, see, 8 years have passed. See, since I placed my cherry tree seed in the grass, must have a tree of my own, I said. Means here in this line, third line, poet has had a thought in his mind that he wanted to grow a cherry tree. So this line is example of that thought. So because of that, what he had done? He had placed a cherry seed in the grass. This is his action, what he has done. And all these are here, all these lines are examples of, you can say, the process of a small sapling growing into a cherry tree. And finally, in the end here, you can say the poet has given us that now a cherry tree has completely grown. It has blossoms over it. The, you can say, birds are flying around it. They are building their nests. The insects are drinking. The bees are drinking nectar from its blossoms and all. It had grown into a cherry tree. So this is this are the examples for that particular question. After that, pink, fragile, quick to fall. Notice the arrangement of the words in the line. They move from healthy to delicate. Now here, see here. Pink, the blossoms, the flowers which were grown on the cherry tree were pink color. They were very delicate. Fragile means they were very delicate, and because of that, what happened? They were very quick to fall with the slightest breeze and all. So here, when in the line the words are arranged in an ascending order, then you can say the figure of speech used in that line is climax. Here you have to always keep in mind, what is climax? When the words are arranged in successive order or ascending order, then you can say the figure of speech of that line is what? Climax. Here the blossom turns pink and then they ripen and they are ready to be picked. Understood this line? So figure of speech in this of this line is climax. Afterwards, they want you to give example of alliteration, antithesis and personification that we'll see from the poem. Now, alliteration here means what? See here. Swiftly the stars turned in the sky. Or here also see a bloom and the sun sang. When a sound of a particular letter is repeated in the line in a quick succession, then you can say the figure of speech is alliteration. Again, I'm repeating. When the sound of a letter is repeated in the line in quick succession, then it is alliteration here. And the sands and the sun sang. Here, sun sang. The sound of letter S is repeated in the line. So here it is alliteration. Then swiftly the stars in the sky. Here also S is repeated. Then you can say it is alliteration. And moon moths. Here moon moths. It is alliteration. The sound of M is repeated. There are many examples of, you can say, alliteration in the poem. See here, spent a season in Kashmir. Sound of S is repeated in the line again. So all these are what's here? Who watch wondering while? The sound of letter W is repeated in the line in quick succession. So this is also alliteration. As I told you, there are many examples of alliteration in the poem. Afterward, they have asked you to give example of personification. Here, it was very small, 5 months child. Here, the cherry tree is, the growing of cherry tree is compared to a small child. Here, 5 month child. This 5 month child is who? A cherry tree. So, when we give human quality to, you can say, anything, then it is known as what? Personification. So, here human quality is given to a cherry tree. So, that's why the figure of speech in this line will be personification. This is one example of personification. See, a shrivel, the slender stem. This is also an example of alliteration. Afterwards, they have asked you to give example for antithesis. Antithesis here means what? When two opposite words are used in the line, then the figure of speech is antithesis. So here you can say, see here. Come back thinner, rather poor, but richer by a cherry tree at my door. Here the word poor and richer are used in the line. They both are opposite words. They are used in the line. So here for better poetic effect you can say. So for that reason the figure of speech in this line will be antithesis. Come back thinner, rather poor, but richer by a cherry tree. Poor and richer, two opposite words are used in the line. So the figure of speech here will be antithesis. One more example is there of antithesis. See here, I'll tell you. See here. It was very small, 5 months child, lost in the tall grass, growing wild. Small and tall. These two are opposite words. They are used in the line. So figure of speech for this line will be antithesis. They can give you the line and they will ask you to identify the figure of speech in your exam, or they can just give you the figure of speech and they will ask you to find out the example of figure of speech, find out example of antithesis. So here you can tell this one is antithesis. Now, just now I have told you one more example of antithesis. So accordingly you have to write. Rhyme scheme of the poem. Now see here, this one. 8 years have passed since I placed my cherry tree in the grass. Now the last two words, past and grass, are rhyming. So this way the rhyme scheme here will be AA, third and fourth line. Must have a tree of my own, I said, and wanted it once and went to bed. Here this word, said and bed, both are rhyming. So here the figure of speech will be BB. Then fifth and sixth line, and forgot but cherry trees have a way of growing, though no one's caring very much or knowing. So growing and knowing, these two words are rhyming. So here you can say the rhyme scheme of the poem is AA, BB and CC. I hope you have understood how to write the rhyme scheme. Accordingly you can see what is the rhyme scheme here. May, stay, again AA, child, wild, BB, skite, blight, CC. So the rhyme scheme of the poem is AA, BB, CC. This is used while you write the critical appreciation. You should know what figure of speech are used in the poem. You have to write in the critical appreciation. So while analyzing the poem, that time only after the explanation, see what figure of speech are used in the poem, what is the rhyming scheme of the poem. So you can, that will help you to write it at the time of critical appreciation. So I've told you everything now. Let's go to the next question. We have seen examples of this figure of speech. Next one, see. The cherry tree is a narrative poem. Features that make it a narrative poem are given below. Justify them with proper examples. See here, the poem has a beginning, middle and an end. Yes, the poem has a beginning here when the poet has mentioned in the poem that the thought had come into his mind that he should have a tree of his own. Then because of that he puts the seed in his garden. Then everything is mentioned how the cherry tree has grown, and at the end how he is enjoying the cherry tree growing in his garden and he is very happy for that. All these things are mentioned in sequence. So here you can say yes, it is having beginning, middle and end. Different places are mentioned. Yes, the house of the poet, it is mentioned that near his house he had a garden. Then he has gone to Kashmir, that is also mentioned. So this also is correct. Then characters are referred to. Yes, here the different characters are mentioned in the poem, like the grass cutter, or you can say goat, or you can say birds and insects flying, the poet himself flying under the cherry tree and enjoying the nature. Then incidents are arranged in sequence. Yes, the thought, then how he plays the sapling, then you can say how it grows, and then how he enjoys the growing of the cherry tree at the end. Everything are mentioned in sequence. There is a dialogue between the poet and the reader or the character. Yes, there is a dialogue. He is mentioning here how the goat comes, the grass cutter comes and cuts it apart. Then how he goes to Kashmir after that when he returns. So there is a dialogue, you can say. Then it is time bound. Yes, it is time bound. He has mentioned how long it took for a cherry tree to grow. It took 7 years to grow. So all these things are very correct, and because of that you can say it is a narrative poem. Now here they have asked you to compose a poem, that you have to do it on your own. Now after that they have asked you to write a critical appreciation for the same poem. They have given you points with the help of these points you have to write critical appreciation. Now this is our first poem, so I'll tell you how you're supposed to write critical appreciation. See here, first point is about the poem, poet and title. Now students, at the start of the poem only they had given you introduction. In that blue color box they have told you everything about the poet and about the poem and what is the title and all. So from there only you can pick up the lines and you can say write this point here. You can say the poem Cherry Tree is about the poet. Ruskin Bond's ecstasy over the cherry tree which he had planted, which took 7 years to grow. Then the poet is a nature lover. He has written hundreds of short stories, essays, novels, and more than 30 books for children. So all these things are mentioned at the start of the poem only about the poem, poet, and title. Second point is theme, summary, or gist of the poem. Any one you can write. Here I have written the theme of the poem. See here. It is a poem of struggle against adverse conditions. It inspires one to fight against even those who deliberately try to destroy one's effort to achieve one's dream. Yes or no? From the poem we come to know that in this poem the poet is trying to tell us how the cherry tree had struggled to grow into a complete cherry tree, how a small sapling of cherry had struggled to grow into a full-fledged cherry tree. It had overcome all the obstacles or adversities and now it had completely grown. The poetic styles, language, poetic devices used in the poem. Here you can write anything. We can say it is a narrative poem. I have told you what makes it a narrative poem. So here you can mention it is a narrative poem. The rhyme scheme, poetic style, you can say AABBCC. Is the rhyme scheme. Then the figure of speech used in the poem are alliteration, personification, antithesis, and climax, which I have explained to you all. After that, you have to write special features or novelties or focusing elements of the poem. In that, you can tell the special feature of the poem here, like the poem seems to make reader aware that a small effort, if nurtured carefully, without giving up, can bring rich rewards. That is the special feature of the poem. Then what message the poet want to convey from the poem or what moral he wants to give you. So you can say there is a message to fight against adversities, to struggle. And the poet wants to tell us that the struggle, though long, in the end will bear fruit and bring great joy. Because here also the cherry tree had struggled for 7 long years. And then finally it had grown into a full-fledged cherry tree. And last, you have to mention what is your opinion about the poem. Then you can say it is an inspiring poem. The poet has nicely described how a sapling overcomes all the adversities and grows into a cherry tree. Here you can also add if you want more that here. In the same way, the poet wants the poet wants to tell us also that we should not give up in our life. Whatever you can say obstacle or struggles we are facing, we have to overcome that and become a successful person in our life. So in this way you have to write critical appreciation. For every poem you have to write critical appreciation. This question is asked in your board exam for 4 marks or 5 marks. So you have to be well prepared for that. I hope you have understood this. After that, they have asked you to write summary of the poem. In my last lecture, I have explained to you all how you are supposed to write a summary. While writing a summary, you have to just mention the title of the poem, what is the poem about. Then in the main body of the poem, you have to explain what is given in the poem, the main points. And lastly, you have to write conclusion of that poem. It should be whatever is the poem, 1/10 should be the summary of that poem. So I have explained to you all in my last lesson one of the pros how to write a summary. Now for this poem you will write a summary. You will see how you can write a summary. I hope you have understood. Practice both the critical appreciation as well as summary. Thank you.